super glitchy way to make a lot of stubs in MLB The Show 22. If you're new to the channel and you enjoy the content, whether it's XP methods, XP glitches, or stub tips, make sure that you drop a thumbs up on the video, hit that red subscribe button, turn your notifications on. That's it. It's all free to show your support back to me. Let's get into the breakdown. If you're looking for a super, super fun and easy way to earn extra money, follow me on Underdog Fantasy and use code FATDALLAS for a deposit bonus up to $100. All you got to do is come in here, make $1 bets, $2 bets, $3 bets. It don't matter. Choose your players. Come over to the right, put the amount in. $1 bet, you have a chance to win $3 back. I will be giving you guys free picks. Follow me on my Twitter, and I will give you a Discord link, and let's have some fun. All right, so making stubs early in MLB The Show 22 is very, very easy and simple. Make sure that you follow the entire video. Now, the gaps are a little tighter this year compared to the past three MLB The Shows, but I'm gonna help you guys out through that. What you wanna look for is between 2,500 and 3,000 gaps, but you wanna stay under 19,000 stubs. What I mean by that, let's go to the marketplace. All right, so looking on the marketplace, you wanna stay under 19,000 and you wanna try to find between 2,500 gap. So right here, we have Kenny Lofton, 91 overall diamond, 19,677, and then the sell now is 17,105. That gives you about a 2,500 gap, give or take. So what I mean by the gap is, after you make this transaction and then they take the percentage off of taxes, you're gonna be left with about a 650 to 700 stub profit. Now, the best cards that I've been going over is the 90 overalls. So I will go to filter and then I will go to 90 overall. Once you come down here, you can find better gaps. It's usually two to three different cards that's gonna have that gap that you're looking for. This one right here is 2,400. This was a great, great card yesterday. People seen that I was on the market. I made about 17 to 18,000 stubs super, super fast. And then you will start to see it fluctuate. Now, when you get up here to Cody Bellinger, this card is close to a 3,000 gap. You can see that buy now price go up to about 16,900. This would be the perfect card to grab two or three of these and flip them real, real quick for a 1,500 stub profit. Okay, so right here, we are at 2,100 stubs. Okay, so once you go here, you're gonna go back and forth between equipment and players. Right here is the perfect example. This is a 3,000 gap. So after you make the transaction, you will hurry up and put in the order for two to three of these because the market changes every 4 to 5 minutes. This is a 3,000 gap. They're gonna take 1,700 off. That's gonna leave you over a 1,300 to 1,500 stub profit on each and every one that you get for this low price. So if we go in right here, you can see 14,150. It's already changing. Go in there, create buy order, 14,152, okay? I would go in there and get it. Now, somebody already went up to 14,200. Like I said, it's always changing. So you would need that 14,200 to get sold, and then yours will be next. I would let them sit for about 3 to 4 minutes at the most. So that's the reason why I try to buy two to three of this one. I will go down, find another car or another perk or equipment, and I will get two to three of them one. I wanna make 4,000 to 5,000 stub profit on all my transactions in a 5 minute window. You're gonna be easily walking away with 40 to 75,000 stubs if you are just a little bit patient. In between times, I will go play some conquest games on the mystery map. And then in return, I will be able to get more and more free packs. Okay, so every time that you complete the conquest mystery map, you're gonna get five show packs. This takes about 15 minutes. So 15 minutes to 20 minutes to complete this entire map. And then with 15 to 20 minutes, you should make 7,000 to 10,000 stubs on the marketplace. But you don't want to take too much time. You want to go up in here, take 2 to 3 minutes, get some of these filled in. Then you want to back out. If your thing did not sell, then you just go back and you would take it down, because the marketplace is constantly moving. So you don't want your price that you bought them for to all of a sudden, when you sell them back, you can only make a 300 to 400 stub profit, because people are constantly manipulating the market. So if you come to my orders, completed orders, you're gonna see the smaller ones I was doing, buying them 3,128, selling them 3,945. You take 300 off for the taxes, that leaves 800 minus 3 is 500. So I was getting 500, 500, 500, give or take stubs. That's 1,500 stubs in between. Once you get down here to the bigger ones, you can see I was buying these for $22,105, selling them for $25,250. That's over a 3,000 gap, exactly like I told you, okay? They're gonna take 2,500 off. That's gonna leave you with about 500 to 700 stub profit. Now, when you get down here to Lewis Robert, now I'm under 20,000. So I'm buying them for 16,754 stubs and then selling them for 19,437. Okay, close to a 3,000 gap, but only 1,900 coming off. That's more of an 800 stub profit. And then if you go to the next page, you will really see right here is over a 3,000 gap. Buying Ricky Henderson for 13,605, selling them for 16,895. That's a 3,200 stub gap. Once they take 1,600 off, you're making almost a 1,500 profit on each one of these transactions. Just like the CJ Crime was at 17,000, you can sell them for, buying them for 15,000. Super good glitchy method to make a lot of stubs. Like I say, go back and forth between the conquest and your buy orders, okay? You're gonna be able to do the same thing with the perks and equipment. Now, down below in the link in the description is the channel membership. Every other day, I will be posting something and will be giving you 2 to 3 items that are hot right now, because I have more time to be on the game. When I make a video like this on certain items to go after, more people are gonna mess up the gap. So I'm gonna post to the members first. They're gonna be able to get in there, get their 30, 40, or 50,000 stubs super, super fast. And then by the time I post the video, the method will not be ruined. But you can do the same thing with the perks. You can do the same thing with the equipment. As you can see right here, this diamond shoe has about a 3,600 gap. So this is very good. As long as you being able to get them for 3,000 or less, you go up in there 15,205. I will go 3 stubs over what they asking for. So now mine is the highest right here. So it makes it easier for them to sell it to. Now, if this price change, even if it goes down to 18,800, 18,700, you are still making a 12 to 1500 stub profit. Now, if the price drops all the way down to 17,000, all you got to do is be patient for 6 to 7 minutes and the price will work its way back up, because as you can see, 18,000 and 19,000 and 20,000 is to the left hand owned column. How easy it is to sell all these orders. Now, I had like 400,000 stubs. I went and opened a lot of bundles. That's my problem, because I gotta learn how to save my stubs. I should have almost 500,000 stubs right now. But in the next 3 to 4 days, I will be back over 200 or 300,000 stubs using all these glitchy stub methods in the game. Go in there, get you 2 to 3 cards. Go into Conquest, get your free packs. Come back in there, get you 2 to 3 cards. And in 15 to 20 minutes, you will have 30 to 40,000. And then you let your packs accumulate and you never know what you might pull out of your packs. Find that 2,600, 2,700 gap up to 3,000 gap and go crazy. Let's go.